They created the penalty.
And you work on it so much. You work on it so hard. But it's tough to simulate game speed in practice. That often runs you into a penalty.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14. On first down, they run with Howard. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. They'll come up now on second and a yard. Running out of the gun here, Breida. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell 3 times with passing touchdowns. But guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
On first down, Howard. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Again, it's Howard. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. From midfield, here's Tua. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 2 catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Tua again. This is Howard. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. From the 28, it's second and 5. On play action, here's Tua. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. First time they looked his way in this game, he comes through picking up the first. Tua now on first down. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. From the 21, it's second and 10. Tua setting up shop to throw again. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Well, it looked like a quick hitter, a 3-step drop. But when it's not there, what do you do? He elects to try and escape through the massive bodies up the middle, and he does so and picks up positive yardage.
And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. Second down at 5. Looking to pass. Tua. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up third down. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Dolphins are going to jump back in front.
So whatever happened to rookie quarterbacks taking time to adjust to life in the NFL? Because this guy looks like he's been doing it for about, what, 7 years? 4 touchdown passes? That's not something rookies are supposed to be doing with the ease in which he's doing it.
Now Tua. And that is caught for the 2 points.
Take it back! Take it back!
And the formula there on the two-point try to go five wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
The Charger drive about to get going. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. 7 yards there and a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level. One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Herbert setting up to throw on first down. On the screen, this is Eckler. And down inside the 15 he goes. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line. Raekwon Davis just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. He finds his receiver, Williams, for a Charger touchdown. Mike Williams there to make the grab. And the Chargers have once again taken the lead.
Brandon, remind me again, this is a rookie quarterback we're seeing?
A rookie indeed.
I mean, because my eyes are telling me something I'm having trouble believing. 5 touchdown passes. He's thrown 5 in this game. Are you kidding me?
No real hesitation from Anthony Lynn. They're going to go for 2. Out of the gun, Herbert. And they don't get it. They tried for the 2-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. And in the third quarter here, they were trying to push that to a 3-point game, but instead it'll stay at 1.
And I'm a big proponent of not chasing points or going for 2 too early. But in this case, I understand why. You know, if you kick an extra point, you're just up 2,
yeah,
right? So a field goal still puts the other team ahead. So you go for 2 here and protect the field goal lead. They didn't get it done, though.
Tua and the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at their own 27. Out of the gun, he'll throw. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Third quarter from Miami. This is second and 10. Here's Tua. And this is Parker, complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 16 yards, a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 11 more on that one and another first down. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there the moment the ball gets to the receiver, and he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
A third quarter now to one-point game as they line up second and 10. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Out of the shotgun, Breida. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 19. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. This is Howard on second down. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. And that'll move them a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
This has been an up-and-down, back-and-forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
Flush to his right. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Dolphins are into the end zone.
Well, I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
So now a big play here as the Dolphins will go for the 2. Going to the air, Tagovailoa, looking in zone, but it's incomplete. The third time wasn't a charm. They got the first 2 2-point tries, still have the lead, but couldn't get the third.
Okay, so they didn't get this one, but I have to ask you, what matchup are they seeing that they feel that confident to go for 2 so often?
Yeah, we talk about this a lot, but it has to be something, you're right, that they saw all week, correct?
Definitely game plan for, felt good about being aggressive and going for it. And right up until that one, they had gotten 2 for 2.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. That throw into the arms of Allen. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. He completes it to Henry. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 3 yards the gain there, second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. A big spot for the rookie Herbert. He'll get this to Eckler. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down. From the 50, here's Herbert. For Keenan Allen, that's complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. On first and 10, Herbert. And his throw here's incomplete. He was looking for Mike Williams that time, but it'll be second down. From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. Complete. Hunter Henry with a grab. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it.
And the pass to Henry is intercepted. Picked by the rookie Noah Igbinoghene. A big seam, and he might go all the way.
You know, they pay me extra for this.
And he will score. Touchdown, Miami.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using five defensive back, six defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
Little flip of fortune. They had a chance to possibly pin him deep, but out of bounds, and now they'll start at the 40.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
A shotgun snap for Herbert. It's Hill, complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. On first down, it's Herbert. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. Second down and 3. From the shotgun, here's Herbert, complete, it's Henry. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 44-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Herbert on first down now. And he's got his favorite target yet again, it's complete. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. This pass finds its way to Williams, and he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 28. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first. First down, Justin Herbert. And caught by Henry. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Joe Reed, the intended receiver. And it's third down. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Gets this one to Hill. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. That one good for 7 as this long drive continues and the chains move again.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him 8. To the air again, Herbert. Henry's got it out on the left side. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. He'll lose a yard on the play, and he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Brandon Jones in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
They'll begin the drive with Howard. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Now a timeout called for by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as it comes with a minute 4 left to go in the game. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. And they take a knee. And the defense, they'll spread the field, a dime package here on third and 12. Down to an knee goes Tua, and that should just about do it.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Dolphins are winners here as we say so long from South Florida.